Greetings and a good evening. Today we will be telling you a story about what would happen if everybody was all of a sudden teleported into the world of Minecraft. This video was inspired by another video from a YouTuber called Magigum. He did a video on a similar topic. However, we will be telling the story from our point of view, not the entire population of the planet. Of course, there are some rules. We all will be using the default resource pack. Everybody who gets teleported is in the default resource pack. The global chat is turned on, so everything you say in chat will be heard by everyone or read by everyone. There is proximity voice. If you have a skin in Minecraft already, that is what you will look like. Otherwise, you're just a thief. All chunks in the world are loaded. The world is in hardcore mode, so if you die, you die in real life. And you spawn where you are on the world map, with the point 000 being the point in the middle of the world map, as shown on screen. There is an inventory, and for the sake of this video, we do not have any friends or family except for us. Now let's set the stage.
Right, so what would happen to us if we got trapped in Minecraft? We would die. But for the sake of the video, what if we did not? When all of this first goes down, people are gonna be panicking. There's gonna be chaos everywhere. So our first priority is to get away from all that. From our position on the map, the most logical vector is to go north. Away from everyone else. We will do some resource collecting, but most of the time during the day we would be traveling, moving north, away from everyone else and to relative safety from, well, quite frankly, panicking people. At night we would need to set up camp to hide from mobs. We can't risk dying to a stray creeper or a skeleton firing squad. In these camps our time would be spent crafting, mining. The mining, of course, would preferably be spent digging tunnels and not caving for safety reasons. Further, we could fish in puddles in our base to collect food without having to go outside. Campfires provide free fuel for cooking food, which is extremely useful, which means we only need to use our coal for lighting up tunnels and bases and cooking down ores. During our travels, we would pick up many interesting resources. We do not know what kind of resources we will need, as of course no one knows if we will ever be able to leave Minecraft again. So anything and everything might be valuable. It would be a long journey spanning many biomes. We would do our best to avoid people as they are unpredictable at best. So during this journey, over time, our equipment will get better, we will collect buckets. And we will search for gold, which is very important for our plan. But furthermore, every bit of time spent fishing is a bit of an investment into potentially getting enchanted books, treasures, and all other kinds of stuff that you can of course get from fishing in Minecraft. Now eventually our equipment will be upgraded enough, and we will have collected sufficient gold, where we feel comfortable making our way to the Nether. Gold helmets on head, of course. But first, we need to build the portal. To build the portal, we find a lava lake. And we use the buckets we collected and divided before to build a portal. Next, when we go into the Nether, we secure our area to make sure we don't instantly die. And after that, we go find some piglins. Make sure the piglins are in a safe spot with some warped fungus to keep away the hoglins. And then we start trading. All of our gold away. Of course we're safe because we're wearing gold helmets. And during this trading we collect as many enderpearls, obsidian and of course fire resistance potions as we can. Our next step is to use these fire resistance potions to go farm a bunch of blazes. To get all of the blaze powder we need to make potions. The next step, as not shown above, is to go kill some ghasts. For ghasties, of course. After that, we use the nether, because you travel 8 blocks in the overworld for every block in the nether, to fast travel even further north. Further away from civilization. Once we feel like we've gone north far enough, we build a portal using the obsidian we got from the piglins, and we go back to the overworld. And in the overworld, we will find the lava lake. Because... now we are getting to our endgame. We built an obsidian base hidden in the lava. We keep getting gold, and we use it to get more fire resistance potions so we can keep getting in and out of our base. Our base has a fishing spot so we can keep getting food and mending books to enchant and repair our equipment. We built potion brewing stands. Crafting, still campfires because it's the cheapest and we are stingy. But it could still be better. We still need one thing. So I hop into my boat and I head over to the closest civilization. And I trade for a shulker box. I make sure no one can stop me from getting home by getting teleported back using an Enderpearl stasis chamber that we set up before. And now, with this shulker box I can use the only duplication glitch I know of that does not use unloading chunks, as this is not possible with our rule set. If you rename a shulker box with items inside of it, and you break the anvil when you change the name, there is a certain percentage chance that the item gets duplicated. So we do this to gain rare materials, get more potions, get better gear. We get ourselves some crossbows, we make and duplicate end crystals and obsidian for defense reasons. And then, that message was the only thing we had to go off of, so we had to assume it's true. We scrambled to grab our equipment and made our way to the stronghold, which at that point was already guarded by people who believed being sent to Minecraft was some sort of divine punishment and no one would be allowed to leave. Luckily, they did not know there was a second end portal. So we went there. Assuming guards were on the other side, we sent through some TNT to blow up the area before us, and then we went through utilizing fire resistance and invisibility, hoping we would be able to get through. After that, the smaller portals were of course also compromised to get to the outer end, so we made a flying machine and flew our way out there. After that, it was just pretty smooth but careful travel through the end, of course, until we made it to the border. We used the old boating through the border trick to get out. We started taking border damage and then we made it out.
And that marks the end of the story of what would happen if we, along with everybody else, were teleported into the world of Minecraft. We hope you enjoyed this video, and we hope you would like to see more of it. If you do, consider subscribing. We thank you for watching, and let us know what you thought in the comments down below. Thank you guys, see you next time.